Okay. Struggle with death or how I survived my Fitbit app. I struggle not only with death, I struggle with the language. I'm very sorry about it. I will give my best. Okay, thank you. So, I wear a Fitbit tracker about 3 years. Many people ask why. I use a Fitbit, small thing. I use it because I'm a workaholic and I like to take care about others, but not about me. And sometimes I felt there was something wrong with my body, and I need to know what it is. And I found a book, Fitness for Geeks, and I gave them a chance, and I like it very much. So, what's the matter? Everybody says, lose weight, do sports, it will be better. Who in society screams, lose weight, do sports? Here's this way to live. Been there, done this. Sometimes lost weight, sometimes gained weight. Everybody knows, I think. But I really became more active. This was really fine. Cut. Back to start. Fitness trackers are focused on society goals. Losing weight, being more active. Sometimes it works. Sometimes really not. I'm dealing with a weird illness for many years, about 14, I think. And last year, it became very dangerous to me. I was not able to eat. There was no hunger, no appetite. I lost 35 kilo within 9 months. I had to change the goal. It was very simple. It was only not to die, ergo not to lose more weight. My body is not my ally. It sends corrupted signals, and it don't like carbs. My Fitbit app shears while I'm dying. This is a view if you are logged in the Fitbit website. In our brains are colors, signals. Green is good, green is fine, green is great. Red is bad, red is serious, red is not fine. Yellow means attention, listen to me. And if this is a view of a very good day for me. I have enough calories, the balance between the foods are good for me, a lot of fat, a lot of proteins, and less carbs. But the comment is, oops. You have got too much calories, and it's very difficult to change the switch in the brain with the comments and with red and with green and with yellow. And the Fitbit app for a smartphone gives the same view. Red calories too much, but it was a really good day for me. Yes, and this is an overview to a week. And the red days are good days for me because I got enough power. The green is okay, sometimes it's okay. But the yellow are dangerous because I lost muscles and I hadn't enough energy for my activities and for my life. I was very angry. Because it's my device, these are my data. Why can't I define the goals for these gadgets? Programmers, what are you doing there? When did you start to do things that society dictate? No hero came to rescue me. I had to rescue myself once again, but I'm not a programmer. normally I do boring office stuff and sometimes I deal with IT tasks, but I'm not a programmer. I was angry about the closed device and application. There was no chance to get my data from the gadget directly. Sometimes I ranted about this, and on one day, a programmer showed me the Fitbit API. Big data should be my alley. But how to use an API? Nobody wanted to do the job for me. By myself, I hadn't enough time and patience for learning. I was tired and powerless, and I gave up. What do I need? I need an easy way to track my data. I need an individual evaluation of my data in real time. I need a reminder, and I read some kind of digital nanny who pokes me, because I didn't care about myself. And then, during the CAS Communication Congress in last December, I was sitting in the CBIS assembly, and there was a magic moment. I absorbed the spirit of coding. I got an idea. The Fitbit app isn't crappy at all. The databases for food and activities are very fine, and the data input is very comfortable. And so, I got a solution. I use the smartphone for tracking and displaying. I use the Fitbit API to supply the data and a Python script to evaluate the data. The Twitter API I use for notifications, and Twitter clients on different devices are my digital nannies. I wrote a Python script. Writing means searching by Google and Stack Overflow, reading library documentations, sometimes understanding library documentations, asking a friend who was sitting in another assembly, tearing my hair out, drinking coffee, and sometimes writing code. This is my script. This solution is not really good. If you are interested, it's on GitHub. What does it do? It reads the real-time data from the Fitbit database. It compares some parameters with predefined values, predefined by me, not by society. The parameters are carbs, because my body don't like carbs, and the input and the output of food energy and the balance between these parameters. Differences between input and output of food energy and the total amount of carbs will be displayed. So there are no colors to signal anything. It says input calories, output calories, total amount of carbs, and a comment, you shouldn't eat something. Or if the balance is very big. Because not the right word. Okay, then it says that you have to eat something or so on. Genau. So, if specified values are exceeding or falling below a specified limit, it prints a note at the display and sends a direct message per Twitter to me. I receive the DMs on every device with a Twitter client. My notebooks, my PCs, my tablet, my smartphone. The smartphone signals a vibration alert. These are my digital nannies. The script is running on a server at my home office. Per cron job, it is querying the database every hour. And I also can it triggered manually if I need the data on time. I can react at time. I will not forget to eat enough in balance to my activities or to rest if I'm not able to eat enough. I can decide which kind of food is still possible for me at a day. And green, red, and yellow are obsolete. I ignore them. summary. It works well. I'm still alive, and I hope I still stay alive. I'm the living proof. Angry non-coders are able to code with a little help from their friends. My note to coders and developers, share your knowledge with your non-coding friends. Poke them. Give them ideas to solve problems with code, because non-coders don't get ideas to solve their problems with code, because they have no imagine what could be a solution for their problems. My note to non-coders, start coding. Ask coding friends where to find solutions for your ideas or problems. Go to hackerspaces or to other coding areas to get the magic spark of coding. Really, it works. I know it. And last but not least, cheers for hackerspaces. We need more of them. And cheers for people like you, which encourage others to start coding. We need more of them too.
We are.